I really can't stay.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I gotta go.
But baby, it's cold.
All right, so I'm gonna go to the NOAA solar calculator here and zoom in on property here. All right, so I've got this centered where my solar tracker is. Now I can click on where the sun's going to come up, this direction, where the sunset is. That's where the sun's going to go down. So you can see we don't really have a lot of angle to the sun today. Sun's supposed to come up at 7:26 local and go down at 4:36, believe it or not, in the afternoon. So not a lot of angle of the sun today, but it's going to be a sunny day. Let's look at the clouds. All right, so we're going to go to IntelliCast, enter our zip code here, and it'll come up with some options here for the satellite. Click on the interactive weather map. It'll start to bring it up your area. Let's click on the clouds. You can see you got a little window of blue this morning. We should get some sun. Click on the animate here. See what's going on, which way the clouds are coming in. So we'll have a few hours of good sun, then that might be it.
All right, it's almost sunrise here. Let's go see if the tracker's gonna on cue head towards the east here. It's about a little after 7 o'clock. All right, here we go. Tracker's scheduled to wake up and head to its east position and wait for the sunrise. So it's just going to be a little bit south of east. And there we go, there's the sun. Going to be coming up over those houses there. So it's going to be a good solar day. Let's look at the wall and see what the grid ties are like. One of the things people were asking about is, do these grid ties use any power when at night or when the sun's not up? And you can probably see on here, they're all zeroed out. And none of them are awake yet. So we'll just wait for the sun to come up and go from there. Batteries are full. Alright. So we'll see what's going on right now. Oh yeah, these clouds coming through here. Trackers. Perfect position. And we'll see how long it lasts. Alright, looks like we're tracking at about, I think about 43 on that panel. And our larger ones are in the 50s, 45, 50. For a total of 260, 270. Take what we can get.
All right, going back onto this IntelliCast site with the cloud view. Until I got this window here, I zoom out, I can kind of see how big and how stretched out this cloud mass is. The other nice thing about this particular satellite view is it actually works 24 hours a day, so it's not something that's impacted by the sunlight. So check it out.
All right, did a little noon check here. 440 degrees out. Clouds picked up a little bit. Not too bad. Tracker, got it nailed. Check the wall. All right, here. Put it on macro. You can see here about 85 watts on the tracker. That's about what I'm getting on my large stationary panels. And a total of 464 today. Not too bad. See by the shadow, we're just a little bit past solar noon as far as these panels are concerned. So pretty much full power right now. Going to the tracker. Looking good. There's the sun there. See the shadows from these trees on the ground are getting kind of long. It won't be long, and they'll be encroaching on that. So any trees that are just at the horizon, they'll cast a shadow, and they'll get you. All right, so here we are at the end of the day. Just got 3.6 watts coming in on all the panels. If I go to the EC setting, which is the energy consumption, which in this case is energy contribution, you can see it reads 2.17 kilowatt hours is how much we were able to produce today with our solar panels and our short day. Pretty cool. Catch you later. I really can't get over that old doubt. Baby, it's cold.